The names of the 18 commissioner nominees are Yekini Idiaye Akokoedo, Paul Uhombamu Ego, Barrister Emmanuel Agbale, Esan Central, Emmanuel Osu, Esan Northeast, and Madeleine Ohen, Esan Southeast. Others are Amilome Osaon, Esan West, Joseph Goke, Esako Central, Mikael Amonuhai, Esako East, Marian Abubakar, Esako West, Osaji John Inigbedion, Igwebe, Ireminona, Eduo Dion Oye, Gobaoha, and Professor Yinka Omoregbe, Oedu, Osaze Osewegi Ero, Orion, Monday Osaigbabu, Ovia Northeast, Dr. Christopher Desutu, Ovia Southwest, Jimo Ijegba, Owan East, Okuns Regina, Owan West, and Dr. David Osifu, Uhunwode. The Speaker, Justin Okunobo, requested the nominees to submit 30 copies of their credentials to the House for screening.
I would like to instruct all those whose names appear here to submit 30 copies of their credentials to the Office of Minority Leader, not later than 1 p.m. tomorrow, the 21st of June 2017.
Meanwhile, Edo State Grazing Bill has scaled through second reading after deliberation by the lawmakers. Chief sponsor of the bill, Bright Osayande, who was supported by majority of the members, said the bill was long overdue considering the atrocities herdsmen allegedly have perpetrated across the state, pointing out that the issue needed to be nipped in the bud permanently.
Farmers cannot go to farm anymore. They are free to go to the farm. The market women cannot go to the market, they are afraid to go to the market. The children cannot go to school, they are afraid because of territory. What is being seeking, sir, that they should have a designated area, a restricted area.
What will make the herdsmen to invade a school and put our children under trauma by invading their classroom? It was a woeful day. The trauma the children went through, I believe that if they are in their classes now, they will still be looking at the windows whether the cows are coming.
Mr. Speaker, last week you will recall that a woman from my place who challenged herdsmen for grazing on her farmland was murdered with a cutlass in Ebu, a part of my constituency. Some women were raped to death. Yes, men, the activities in this state is not encouraging, it's inimical to the progress of this state.
The bill, when we finally pass into law, will enable the farmers to go freely to their farm and do their own work.
Some other members also called for public hearing so as to give opportunity to Edo people to contribute, as the Minas has not only become security risk but has assumed a frightening dimension.
We can go on and on, produce a very beautiful document. At the end of the day, those who are in charge do not have the political power to implement this because they generate a lot of revenue from these other people who are doing
This bill is timeless.
Mr. Speaker, I don't think this is a bill that this House alone, even though we are the representatives of the people of Edo State, can conclude. The committee that will eventually handle this matter before it is again brought to this House for deliberation should consider the possibility of recommending a public hearing.
If my people from my constituency is saying that the bill should rather be anti-grazing law, because what you have here has to do with restriction of these animals. By the time you create a ranch, you are putting them in one static environment where they cannot go beyond that area, Mr. Speaker.
The Speaker, Justin Okunobo, said the bill would not have come at a better time than now. Also during plenary, the Speaker reconstituted the House committees, which were earlier dissolved. Sitting continues. Efosa Wangwe reporting.